Hey guys, this is a video to my subscribers. I felt like it was an important video to do because things had started out very low-key and have gotten very public very quick. No doubt you have probably heard, and you may hear, you know, Paul and Tom, TLG847, I think Ken RG, Perry Irvin, there were some people that were talking about this YouTube thing. You know, it's not working anymore. And when I first, Tom and I have had lots of conversations about what works on YouTube and what doesn't. I have a great respect for Tom because of his background as a clinical psychologist, but because of his professional career as well. So we hit it off pretty good, especially when I met him at 777 and Karen, and just we hit it off. And I've talked to him frequently about YouTube and the problems with YouTube and the fact that it's such an unresponsive environment. So these folks have just been talking about, what would you do different? If you could have a social video network site, what would that look like? I mean, if it was you, if I was asking you that question, what would you like to see? What kind of features would you like to see? So we talked about the fact that YouTube, by its very nature, encourages bad behavior. Why? Well, on YouTube, it's all about views, and it's all about numbers of subscribers. How do you get views on YouTube? Well, you're either talented or you piss somebody off. You either know what you're doing and are very creative, or you create drama. And YouTube doesn't care either way as long as it generates views. So it encourages, it's like a petri dish of bad stuff that grows. Many of you that are watching this video have had interactions with haters here on YouTube. Not just the people that come by and say, hey, you're fat or ugly. I mean, you know, the people that I talked about in my cyberstalking video, really nasty people. Evil. I call them evil. I mean, I call it that way. So you get tired of that. You really get tired of that. I mean, think about when you first came on YouTube. And you had that initial kind of adrenaline rush of, wow, there's people out here from all over the world that I can talk to. This is so cool. I'm finding people that have similar interests, finding people I like, people I would never meet in my coffee shop. And so it's really exciting until you run into all the bad crap. So in this discussion that these guys have been having for well over a year, they've talked about some of the things that they'd like to do with a site to make it better. It finally got to the point where they realized they needed to have something to start with. They needed to have a bigger conversation than just the few of them. Even though, to be honest with you, I've talked about many of the suggestions or concepts that I had for a better site, these guys are sharp. I mean, they've pretty much thought of all of it. And it wasn't Paul Renetto that got me to get involved in this. It was Tom. Because, like many of you, I had my own perceptions about where Renetto was coming from. And when I got into this group by invitation, I realized that Paul's a real person. I mean, a real person. And he's actually a nice guy. And he's got some great ideas. And he's very passionate about this. I have seen people vlog on this site in ways that I have never seen on YouTube. I have seen people just open up and relax, sit back in their chair, talk to people. I can honestly say that I have met people that I've seen on YouTube. I've watched their videos. I've watched their creativity. but I've never watched them. This is the first place that I've actually seen who they are. I've actually talked to who they are. The real them, not the personas, not the projections, just them, because they're comfortable doing that, like it used to be in the old days here. Paul and Tom and Perry and Ken and whoever else are involved, they needed to pull some people in to look around and say, you know, here's what we're thinking about doing. They pulled in a wide range of people. But it's only a small handful in the bucket of YouTube. I mean, it's you know, 40 to 60 people. I mean, it's nothing. It started out with a half a dozen or a dozen. There are certain, and we've had a lot of discussions about what would make a good site. And like I said, these guys are sharp. They thought of most of this stuff. Some of the features that they say are absolutely, you got to have it before you can start opening the doors, are things like verified identity. This site will not allow you to create multiple accounts, and you won't be able to be anonymous. You will have to have your identity verified. This cuts out a whole bunch of crap. We've talked about this before, the accountability and the fact that people go out the front door, come in the back door, make multiple accounts, they comment or on their own videos. All that crap. And just to make a quick statement about this business, this Reed guy, NewWarriorMan, I think is his name or something, I don't know. I didn't know anything about this guy. Never, I don't think I've ever watched one of his videos. But he came on the site and kind of, at first, we kind of thought he was playing, you know, poking at certain people on the site. You know, like, I'm playing with y'all. But it got kind of mean pretty quick, you know? And the interesting thing about this site is that I saw something that I would never see on YouTube. Instead of people say, you know, egging him on because it's drama, it's going to get views, let's get involved, let's pick a side, yeah. People were kind of looking at it like, you know what? You want to do that kind of crap, go back over to YouTube, because that's not what we had in mind here. And it's not what we're trying to build here. I mean, we're not trying to build a Pollyanna world or anything like that. It's just a place where people respect each other and can work out their differences in a respectful way. Some level of personal integrity. And you've seen the level that fights go to here on YouTube. And they're totally out of control because the site does nothing. One of the very basic rules that we had established early on was the fact that in order for people to be open and honest and give honest feedback to Paul and Tom and Perry and Ken, we wouldn't be sharing videos outside of the community, outside this group of people. Reed violated that rule. I'm not even going to go into the details because it just doesn't matter to me. The first thing he did was post an ugly video on YouTube talking about this particular site, knowing full well that everyone that was out there had been asked not to really talk about it. Not because it's big secret, not because it's, ooh, all these special people. I sure as hell ain't special. It's because Paul, as I've discovered, is actually a real person. And he said, look, if people don't get invited, they're going to consider it like a YouTube thing. Like you're not in the in crowd and we're not inviting you. And that's not what we're trying to do. We're trying to get this thing together to the point where we can make it work on some extremely basic level with the things that we said we have to have in place before we start inviting a whole bunch of people over here or throwing open the doors to the public. We can't do it because it will turn into a YouTube just like that. The cool thing about the Reed situation was Reed started getting a bit, what I consider to be personally, childish and poking at people in a kind of an ugly way. And instead of the community saying, yeah, fight, everybody stepped back and said, why are you doing that? Are you just trying to aggravate people? Are you just trying to start a fight? That's not why we're here. He apparently took exception to that. And it hurt his feelings. And so he took his ball and went home. And started kicking it around YouTube. The video that he posted on YouTube was to me, it was a total breach of ethical integrity. But then when he took Renato's video and posted it out on live video, he took the embed code and posted it on live video. That was an ethical line that for me was just over the top. Because people on this site have been very open and honest, in some cases emotional, in some cases passionate. And we can do that because we know that, you know, there aren't haters here that are going to grab your video and make a fool of you. We're all here to talk to each other in an adult way. So that person took that video, put it on live video, and to me that was it. And I am very glad to tell you that it was not very long at all after that that the leadership that's involved in this particular project at this point said, that's crossing the line. You're out. And you know what? They're out as in, you're not coming in the back door. You're not going to create another account and come in. You're not going to create a multiple accounts and attack people. You're just gone. So in my mind, it was definitely a win. Because I realized, yeah, you can do this. If you do it right, you can do this. You can have a site where people can disagree, but when it gets down to building fake accounts and answering back to your own videos and calling people at their house and doing ugly stuff, you're out. And guess what? Your identity is verified. You get too far out of line, turn your ass over to the cops. Accountability, responsibility, oh my God. So Paul's not upset, or any of them are upset because Reed came out here playing his childish games. He was more upset because he didn't want people to think that if you aren't in, you must be out. If you're not part of the clique, because that's the way it is on YouTube, you've seen it, you know, well, I'm part of the, I'm going to pick a name, you know, the Nalt's followers. So if something happens with Nalt's, I'll get invited. If I don't get invited, I must not be important in the clique. This is not about cliques. This is about trying to create something that's like real. This is like taking the internet paradigm and shoving it up on its head, kicking it in the butt, and saying we're tired of the internet being a free-for-all and a playground. We're tired of people not being held accountable and responsible. We're tired of not having a place where we can go and we can vlog and we can have intelligent conversation without all the din and the noise, without the bar chairs flying across our head because somebody's broken out in a bar fight and the owner of the place doesn't have a bouncer. I guarantee you this place is going to have a bouncer. So, for my subscribers, if you've heard that I'm involved in this, I am. I am involved in this. I'm very excited to be involved in this because I think it has some real potential if they can figure out technically how to do some of the things they want to do. And it's not about being in a clique. It's not about numbers of subscribers. I don't have that many subscribers. There's people in this group that have less subscribers than I do. It's not about that. And it's not about trying to keep anybody out. Oh no, I don't want to let that person in because they're part of that clique. It's not like that at all. It's trying to keep the group small enough so that there's kind of a one degree of separation. So everybody kind of knows who everybody else is and they are comfortable that someone has kind of vetted the person that's in there. And the group is small enough so that you can have some really tough conversations about how far do we go with free speech versus accountability? How far do we go with privacy versus accountability? You know, what are we going to do about child safety? What are we going to do about people that come in and try and do something crazy? What are we going to do about copyright? What are we going to do about DMCAs? All of these very complicated issues. And guess what? You know how long this particular group has been talking to each other? 10 days. 11 days. They haven't even... We haven't even figured out how to do some of the things in the site that you're supposed to be able to do, and we got a couple of volunteer programmers that are in there pulling their hair out trying to help us out get something in place so that we could kind of expand it and say, come on in, look around, see what you think. So this whole read thing has really bothered me because it has given people the impression that there's some kind of click going on, some kind of club, you know, elitist club or something. And that's not what it's about. Not what it's about at all. And I'm here to tell you, if they can do this, if they can do 50 or 60% of the things that have been talked about in that group that are part of this vision or concept or whatever, I would go over there in a heartbeat and I'd never look back at YouTube. I'm here to tell you. In a heartbeat. So, just wanted y'all to know, if you've heard my name involved in it, you know, and, oh, why didn't Tim invite me? I'm not doing the inviting to begin with. It's a very controlled environment. And it's the concept of bringing in people that have certain, for example, in my case, some experience with haters. You know, I've had a minor run-in here and there with them. Somebody else who's really done a lot of DMCA works. Here, somebody else worked on copyright. Here's somebody else that does programming, for example. Here's somebody else that does this. Here's somebody else that does that. And we're going to bring all these people in here. And we're going to try and talk about, what would you like a site to look like? Now, imagine if you're doing that yourself. You can't open that to 1,000 people, 10,000 people. How can you have a conversation? But I guarantee you, over time, if they can get some of these technical things worked out to make it, to implement some of the basic concepts that we've talked about, verified identity, being on the top of the list, there'll be more people involved. And consider a sales pitch if you want to. But if they're able to do this, I guarantee you, you won't look back. Not if you're interested in vlogging. You won't look back.